Dear audience,
hello, today is Sunday, March the 11th. Welcome to ICN News. I'm Rock.
I'm Michelle. Let's preview our headlines today.
The 11th MPC reviewed the work reports by the Supreme People's Court and the Supreme People's Procuratorate. The center of the report is enforcing the law with justice and honest.
Seize the opportunity, Bill Green Jiangxi, ICN's exclusive interview with Jiangxi Provincial Governor and MPC Deputy Lu Xinshe.
Hubei Provincial Governor Wang Guosheng received ICN's interview and talked about the economic cooperation and the cultural exchange between Hubei and America.
Mao Xinyu proposed to fight against corruption and build a clean government and appeal to learn from Mao Zedong.
Zhou Qing, the Provincial Party Secretary who was born in the 1960s, said, "I'm not a naked official."
Let's see our news today.
中华人民共和国第十一届全国人民代表大会第五次会议 3月11日下午在北京人民大会堂举行第三次全体会议，听取最高人民法院院长王胜俊做最高人民法院工作报告，并已审议；听取最高人民检察院检察长曹建明做最高人民检察院工作报告，并已审议。
About the Supreme People's Court's work, Chief Justice Wang Shengjun stated the persistence of the center of the administration of justice and the working principles of serving the people and judging for the people.
一要着力发挥审判职能，为经济社会发展提供更加有力的司法保障；二要着力深化司法改革，让司法能力让改革成果切实惠及人民群众；三要着力加大队伍建设力度。 进一步提高法院队伍整体素质；四要着力解决基层存在的问题，不断提高人民法院基层建设水平；五要着力完善接受监督机制，促进司法公正。
In the report, Chief Procurator Cao Jianming said, 2012 is an important year for it's the last year of the 12th five-year plan. Procurators should center around the overall situation of economy and society and carry out the supervision, especially be strict on the crimes by taking advantage of duty committed by officials.
加大查办和预防职务犯罪工作力度，依法严肃查办发生在领导机关和领导干部中的职务犯罪案件，严重损害群众经济权益、人身权利、民主权利的案件。 发生在工程建设、房地产开发、土地管理和矿场资源开发等领域的案件，破坏生态环境、重大责任事故、食品药品安全事件涉及的案件，执法司法领域贪赃枉法、徇私舞弊的案件，以及充当黑恶势力保护伞的案件。
From the work reports of the Supreme People's Court and the Supreme People's Procuratorate, we can see holding justice and improving the harmony of the society are still the forte of the work this year for the preparation of the opening of the 18th Party Congress.
ICN 记者张文浩，中国北京，人民大会堂现场报道。
On the morning of March the 11th, ICN reporter had an exclusive interview with Jiangxi Provincial Governor Mr. Lu Xinshe in Conference Center of National People's Congress.
Lu Xinshe hoped to further strengthen the cultural exchanges between the U.S. and Jiangxi. Jiangxi's idiomatic porcelain art and dance could be shown in America. Welcome the U.S. performing groups to Jiangxi and learn about Jiangxi. The government will give active help and support for the communication.
我们初步考虑可以把江西的精品陶瓷、陶瓷艺术展到美国不同的地方去展示，可以把中国的或者我们景德镇的这种一种叫做雌魂的舞蹈，美轮美奂，还有一种这个瓷器的乐队，他这个乐队的瓷器，他乐器啊，全部是用瓷做的，我看过，这是叹为观止。到美国去演出，可以使海外的朋友，了解江西，认识江西。我们也欢迎，美国，一些演出团体啊，像百老汇这些精品的演出。能到我们江西来，因为江西有很好的大剧院，很好的演艺中心，我想这个交流选双向的。
Huoyang Lake Ecological Economic Zone has become the golden signboard of Jiangxi. Lu Xinshe also expressed that he was very proud of it. He said Jiangxi attracted foreign investment through it.
鄱阳湖生态经济区建设是经中国的中央政府 批准实施的一个国家级的战略规划。实施这个鄱阳湖生态经济区的建设，核心有这么几句话，叫做特色是生态，核心是发展，关键是转变发展方式，走出一条经济与生态协调发展的路子。这就是搞这个生态经济区建设的本质要求。我有信心能够在发展经济的同时保护好江西的生态环境。
江西省的那个政府工作报告里边，我留意到您说这个在今后服务业要在 GDP 里面比重加强，在这方面您是怎么样的一个思路？
扩大内需是我们将来发展经济的着力点。另外呢，江西现在的三产服务业比全国的水平低了10%。低本身并不完全是坏事，它预示着潜力。
After interview, Lu Xinshe expressed his gratitude to overseas Chinese through ICN and other overseas media. He hoped that overseas Chinese could love China and concern Jiangxi. He also expressed that Jiangxi government will provide a good environment and better facilities for the exchanges and cooperation.
非常感谢，海外侨胞啊，对我们中国对江西的关心和关注，也非常感谢你们在推荐。介绍中国、介绍江西当中做的贡献，这对大家的期待嘛，我想这样，一个呢，更多的关心祖国，那当然也要关心江西；第二个呢，就是要积极的融入当地，为当地的经济社会发展做出贡献；第三呢，要发挥好桥梁作用，为我们的经贸合作、文化交流、旅游等等，叫做穿针引线、牵线搭桥。增进中国和所在国的这种友谊。
Hubei Provincial Governor Wang Guosheng received ICN's interview and talked about the economic cooperation and culture exchange between Hubei and America. According to Hubei Provincial Governor Wang Guosheng, last year the total export and import volume of Hubei province was $33.5 billion. Foreign investment in actual use was $4.66 billion.93 of the global 500 companies have invested in Hubei. Wang Guosheng emphasized that America had been a major cooperator with the Hubei province in foreign trade and economic cooperation. In 2011, the total amount of bilateral trade between Hubei and America was $3.78 billion. By the end of last year, America had 994 enterprises investing in Hubei. Contractual foreign investment was $1.88 billion.And foreign investment in actual use was $1.3 billion. Many famous enterprises from the United States, including Microsoft, Pfizer, General Electric, have invested in Hubei and are paying off well. In recent years, Hubei also has some enterprises which have been working on investing in America. Last year alone, 12 enterprises applied and were approved. The total amount of investment was $16.36 million.At the end, Governor Wang thanked the abroad media for the attention on Hubei and the promotion for Hubei. He said, Hubei will cooperate with the United States as usual and create a better investment environment.
On March 10th, CPPC member Mao Xinyu received reporters' interview. As Mao Zedong's grandson, Mao Xinyu is always the spotlight in two sessions. Mr. Mao told a reporter that this is the fifth year that he attended two sessions. His former proposals were all related to his grandfather.This year is the first time he turned his attention to anti-corruption and honest government building. He thought socialist construction relies on the people, and the party's construction refutes corruption.
毛泽东主席在中国的革命实践过程中，把历史唯物主义丰富为群众路线。因为我们确实，你比方说，我们共产党打江山，依靠的是人民战争。那么我们搞社会主义建设。要依靠人群众路线，毛主席说的要学习群众，要发挥群众的智慧和积极性，才能搞好建设。所以从各种角度方面来说，我们这个党都不允许有腐败现象存在。我是从这么几个角度说的，当然我还强调了毛主席的典范，以身作则，包括良好的领袖家风。
Mao Xinyu added, he prepared three proposals this year. Anti-corruption and honest government building is the important one. The other two are about national economy development and frontier guards' lives improvement.
In the afternoon of March the 10th, Zhou Qing, the Hunan Provincial Party Secretary, when attending the open conference of the Hunan delegation of the 5th session of the 11th MPC, attracted a lot of media. Zhou Qing talked about the style of the officials born in the 1960s, officials with personalities, migrant workers and naked officials. Zhou Qing, the Hunan Provincial Party Secretary, was born in 1960. He took office in 2010, becoming one of the few provincial officials who were born in the 1960s.
我在工作中最深的体会，就是要全心全意为人民服务，要把维护好实现好、保护好人民群众的利益作为一切工作的出发点和落脚点。作为一个领导干部，只有牢记宗旨、贯彻以人为本、举重为奴的理念。
When asked about naked officials, Zhou Qing said,
比较关注的我关现象，按照我们党的纪律和公务员纪律的要求是非常明确的，一个是重大事项要进行申报，这个个人。 和家庭的重大事项要进行申报。那么，同时我们国家公务员法、我们党内的干部任用条例，对领导干部亲属是否具有外国国籍、是否具有同外国籍公民有通婚的情况要进行报告。所以，我们。 干部任用制度、公务员法对干部的任用要求是非常明确的。就我个人而言，刚才讲到的，我的情况都向总支做了报告，没有裸办的这个问题。谢谢。
After over an hour of media Q&A, some journalists from Hunan province said it was the longest Q&A Zhou Qing had ever taken part in. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.
Bye.